Besides the quite basic patterns, we have two other very important patterns, which are the small world and the scale-free. We will see now the small world. So the small world concept is quite new and developed in the last decades, but has got a large history. The first ones to underline this kind of concept are Solomon and Rapoport in the 50s, who calculated the probability of infection in random graphs. And so they found that the corresponding fraction of infected nodes increase with local redundancy. And so this local redundancy is explained by homophily, by symmetry of edges, by triad closure bias. And so they underlined this kind of patterns also of properties. Milgram also, with the 6-degree separation experience, also underlined the fact that our world has got very short paths between people, and it is another property of the small world. Granovetter, showing the strength of the wake ties or wake links between the groups, took into account the two properties, the fact that we have some groups and the fact that there are some linkage between these groups. And Paul and Cochon in the 70s, but also they began their research quite earlier in the 60s, they showed that we can see that the probability of short paths between people change significantly in a global structure with some local structure. And so he showed also the relation between the two properties. So this is on these properties that Watt and Strogatz developed later their model of small world properties. So the concept they developed have four conditions. The first one is that the network must be quite large numerically, because in real world we have an order of billion people. Also, the network is sparse. Each person is connected to k people in average, and in general the order is 1,000, but it is 100,000 times smaller than the whole population of the planet. So they are not totally connected. Also, the network is decentralized because there are no dominant central vertex. And so the average degree k might be much less than n. But also the maximum degree of the dominant vertices must also be much less than n. And the network is highly clustered because there are friends of friends that are friends, and so circles of friendship. So the characteristic, the general characteristic of the small world would comprise several dense neighborhoods with high clustering, so a high clustering coefficient, and also some short average paths. And these two conditions can be summarized with two measures, which are the average path length that we saw previously as a global measure, and the clustering coefficient, which is an average of local structure, which is complementary to qualify this kind of networks. So Watt and Strogatz, they took some extreme cases. First, for example, the complete graph. The complete graph will have a k very high because all links are linked, or all nodes are linked to n minus 1. And so the average shorted path is really minimal, and the clustering coefficient is maximal. But the problem is that the complete graph does not assume the condition of k largely inferior to n. So we can eliminate this kind of network. Two other important properties of graph are shown by Watson-Strugatz. First, the random graph. Random graph has got a quite low average shorted path because it grows with logarithm of n, but it's got also a quite low, small clustering coefficient because it decreases with n. At the opposite, we have the regular ring graph with an average shorted path which is quite large because it grows with n here, but the clustering coefficient, which is quite large as well because there are a lot of triangles in the graph. So in between these two extreme cases, Watts and Strugatz, they showed that an important and very typical kind of network would be this caveman graph, which is constituted by different communities linked by wake links or ties. And this kind of graph has the property to have a minimal average shorted path, but a maximal clustering coefficient. And so these two properties are the minimal conditions that are both necessary and sufficient for a world to be small. So after this demonstration, they took some examples of movie actors playing together, of power grid of the western state of US, and the C. elegans, which is a neuronal network of the nematode. And they compare the path lengths, average path lengths observed with the random one, which is always a little bit larger, as you see, but also the clustering coefficient observed with the random one, but they produce with the same number of nodes and average degree. And you see here that the clustering coefficient observed is largely superior to the random one. So what they do is that they try to see the properties of all the networks that are in between regular and random, interpolating between both with the same number of vertices or edges in the graph. And so they calculated this random graph by a random procedure with a propensity to connect a new vertex J and a number, according to the number of vertices adjacent to I and G. So what is the propensity to connect to I? And so the average degree of the graph, the propensity of an edge to connect, and a parameter that make like a standardization as alpha. So here they made vary this probability of connection, which is lower if the probability depend only on the neighbors of the nodes, and if it does not depend on their neighbors, it is absolutely random. And they see that as in the decreasing, in the increasing of this p value of increasing randomness, so there is a decrease both of the average path length and here, and the clustering index here. So for regular both values are maximal. For random, both are minimal. And in between, they decrease, but not at all according to the same way. And when we have a low average path length with a high clustering index, it's not so obvious to see the passage because it's continuing between the regular graphs with a high value for both and the random graph with a low value for both. So they applied also this kind of measure and the difference to the random graph to the three kind of graphs they had. So the collaboration graph, this is the observed one, the power grid and the elegance. And so they calculated in this way some kind of random of graph equivalent to caveman here for the power grid, collaboration graph, and elegance. And one see that the difference between random is quite nice according to the clustering coefficient. They managed to simulate quite well this clustering coefficient, but much less the path length. So these research are still developing in order to improve this kind of network, and we will see now another property, which is the scale-free.